What's up, you guys? This is Ray the Gamer here. Welcome back to another stream. Today, everyone, we are playing some more Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 here. Today, everybody, we are going to be flying from Oslo to Longyear, which is all the way up in the island. Might actually be easier if I show you on the, I'm just going to show you in the pilot log. We are flying from Oslo to Longyear in the island of Svalbard, which is the most northern inhabited place on the planet. We're already not doing too well on frames here today, which isn't good. Let's actually open up Task Manager, see how we're doing. CPU's at 100% for some reason. Alright, in the meantime, we've got some 2154s here. This is a historic flight because there were actually 2154s operating flights from Norway to Svalbard. So we've got Rebel Boy also in a 2154. I'm in a 2154 as well. This one actually has a working windscreen and working gauges. Nothing is clickable, unfortunately. That gauge doesn't work. I don't think it works. Right, so let's close a couple of things. Alright. Also, some cool... Alright, I'm going to mute Rev so we can talk, because Rev's in the chat. Alright, so some cool things that I've got today. Hello. So some cool things I've got today is I've got some cool little filters for my stream.
I saw that.
I've got the Russian hat. I've got the bald one. But this one doesn't work too well with my... with my headset, but if I put it away, if I put it down, it works quite well. It looks pretty cool. There's
the bald one looks so weird.
All right, there's
bald
this
one.
One
looks really weird.
This one looks so cool. Then there's the Red Bull helmet. That one looks cool. There's a military helmet, Mandalorian, a bike helmet. I like the bike helmet.
The laser one looks cool.
I like the worm. The worm one looks pretty cool. There's a Viking helmet. Oh, yeah, this looks awesome. This one. So, then I got, okay, that's just a face ID. That's a blue spots. La La Land.
Flight man.
Hello, flight man.
Hi.
All right, we got John. The captain's hat. I'm gonna keep this. Oh, sweet! I got a little parrot too. That is cool. All right, I'm gonna go off this one for now. Check. Hello, flight man 100. All right.
All right. Well, I'm gonna take.
Four viewers, welcome.
I'm gonna go ahead of you and take off.
All right, Windows 10 gamer. Hi. Hello, Windows. Hello, Stancy. Alright.
I can't hear you.
Alright, can you hear me now, flight man?
Even though I'm not.
Hey man, can you hear me?
Okay, I'm gonna turn on my desktop audio just a bit. I reckon that should be good.
Okay. Alright,
in the meantime. Alright, yeah, let's take off.
I just think you ain't pulling up. Oh, that's because I'm on the modern flight model.
Yeah, I actually should make sure I'm on Legacy. I'm getting horrible frames today. I was getting perfect frames before, but now I can't. Okay, yeah, I need to go on Legacy.
But I'm confused how my game didn't crash when I entered Mali. Usually if I enter big airports, Mali's not that big of an airport, usually my game will crash. I think because I did something to my PC, it works much better now, so maybe that's the reason why.
Alright, those engines are spooling up.
I know, all the way.
Alright, we are taking off.
I've got to keep on my flight plan.
Okay, we are taking off. Let's get some music in here.
One, rotate.
Alright, B1, rotate. Alright, gear up. Yeah, I'm not doing too well on frames here, everyone.
Yeah. It just looks nice.
Alright, actually, I think I do know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go into my settings, graphics, and then just lock it in at 20 FPS. That ought to be.
Did Flight Man live? Oh no, he's still here.
Alright, this should be better. Alright.
Man, hold
up. For some reason, I'm deafened in Discord, although I'm undeafened. Why is everyone in here a moderator? Yep, I have free mods, Stancy. I have Flightman 100 is my mod. Rev is also my mod, and so is Ethan Bubeck.
Okay, so I got it fixed now. I can hear you in Discord with something with my sound settings.
Dre, right, I can go in a Sukhoi Superjet 100. That would be a lot more nicer.
I mean, sure, yeah, you could take the Superjet.
Sukhoi Superjet's a lot newer.
Yeah.
It works. So then I have my autopilot set up.
Not gonna be joining, but because I don't have enough time to actually convert.
Oh my god, this plane is pitching up like hell.
Well, this is actually a historical flight. This is that we're reenacting because there were actually 2154s that flew from Norway to Svalbard.
I think I ruined that.
And
mood,
Svalbard actually even had some Russian inhabitants and some association with, the Norwegian island Svalbard had some association with the Russian government. I'll explain that later.
I'm gonna go for 5,000 feet and.
Four viewers, thank you. Thank you, four viewers.
Drew, what's your max speed?
About maybe 550, I reckon. I'm doing 302 right now, but I'm climbing.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna gun it the entire way then.
Doesn't make sense that you're only getting four viewers. Because I know I'm one of them, I know Rev's one of them.
Yeah, but people come and go, you know.
Maybe Dre's one of them, if it counts him. So.
Stency Sebastian is there as well, so.
Oh.
I got 1,000 views on my channel and 20 subscribers.
I have 2,000, over 2,300 views on my channel.
Let's actually see what I got on views.
Got 1,140 views, and guess what? 22 subscribers.
Dre's got 910,000 views.
When my plane just.
Alright, I've got 910,000 views.
Plane decided to just die then. Okay then.
Let's get Dre to a million views.
Alright, and apparently I have no thumbnail. How did that happen?
Did that happen? Nobody knows.
Alright.
Yeah, your thumbnail's just a picture shot before you took off.
Yeah.
I changed my terrain level detail to 100. That seems a lot more better.
I may update my 747.
Alright, I'm climbing a bit too steep and I'm about to stall here.
Andre, Flightman has a 737-800 in an A320 cockpit.
Yeah, I have that one.
Kinda weird.
I like it.
I'm starting to work on getting the 747 back with that one.
I prefer the A321 to be honest.
Just for myself, I think I'm gonna put the fly-by-wire cockpit in it.
Yeah, Dre created an Aeroflot livery for the DC-6.
Dre created the livery for
the DC-6? No, they created the Aeroflot livery for the DC-6. I mean, to be honest, Dre, if the DC-6 worked, you'd probably really like it.
You got the DC-6, Rev?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know. Because... I did get the Captain Sin 777 years ago.
Alright, the autopilot is going to be a pain, of course, on this plane, like it always is.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Right. Five viewers, welcome five viewers.
Five viewers, yay.
We got Rev down there.
And my plane is trying to commit suicide.
Alright, I reckon we'll cruise at about 25,000 feet.
Yeah, so I'm going to maybe try putting the fly-by-wire cockpit in.
Alright.
So I'll start working on that.
My SSJ 100, or Super J 100, just starts going up and down.
Alright, the audio's a bit loud.
The Super Jet's not gonna
How's
work.
The audio looking on the stream, everybody?
It's good.
Alright, let's actually change the filter. Let's go off a, Oh, there's a deer one. This is cool.
320.
What the fuck?
I'm just gonna go.
Yo, look at my filter, guys.
Moose, or whatever.
No, I look like freaking Vladimir Putin. Alright, now I look like a Soviet police officer.
Oh my god, that looks so weird.
And I'm gonna take the Viking one.
I'm gonna be honest, I wish I was a billionaire.
I switched to a A320neo.
If you were a billionaire and you were to buy any plane, what plane would you buy? Like, you could buy any plane.
A350.
A350.
IL-62.
I think I'd probably buy a 757.
I would definitely get an A350 because everybody knows that I absolutely adore the A350.
You absolutely adore the A350.
I adore the A350.
You adore. You adore it. Alright, well.
I really, really like it. I like Ashley.
Would you even consider getting an
A380? Not really. I don't really like the A380. It's just.
To be honest, I don't either. So I'd probably get a 757. Because it's like the sport of airlines.
I know, because, like, here's the thing, the A380 is just a thick version of
Aeroflot just bought an A350, actually. Just a couple months ago.
A bus to Boeing.
What? Trey, what would you get?
I'd get an IL-62 or a IL-96.
I'm sorry, you cut out. Wait.
IL-62 or an IL-96.
You cut out for a minute.
I'd get an IL-62.
An IL-62?
Yeah.
Nice choice.
Or an IL-96.
To be honest, like, if I'm gonna be honest, I think the reason why the Aeroflot for Buster Boeing is because Airbus are European.
Yeah, Aeroflot doesn't operate many Russian aircraft. They retired their IL-96 in 2013 because pretty much after the collapse of the Soviet Union, the only airlines that operated Soviet aircraft were smaller airlines, and big airlines like S7 and Aeroflot started buying up Western aircraft because it's more powerful and more efficient.
Russian, yeah. I would have definitely got Airbus aircraft, because Airbus aircraft, in my opinion, are better than Boeing.
Your team Airbus.
I'm team Airbus.
I don't know. I
team Boeing.
Aeroflot does own some Boeing planes, but not a lot.
I like the 737.
Yeah, the 737 is pretty nice.
I
don't know how to fly it, but I can't wait for the PMDG one. Definitely gonna get that.
Like, buy it?
I will buy it, actually.
Well, buying it would be probably the only way you'd get it anyway. I'm thinking maybe I should, I'll get the PMP one. I won't get
okay,
the
so
PMP.
Onto a different subject.
I'll get the PMP one.
The PMP one is probably gonna be better.
The freeware.
Yeah, freeware is always better.
Maybe it might not be worth it to get the PMP one then.
Yeah, they're probably just gonna be the same, but PMDG is just gonna be better.
At that point, I mean, I'm definitely not gonna be getting PMDG. Because I'm broke. You know, I don't have money.
Yeah, me too, dude. I just got sacked.
My dad gives me £20 for just cleaning the fish. I feel too spoiled.
I don't get any money.
Rip. That's a work I donated it.
Yeah, I'm broke now. I just got sacked from my work.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got sacked.
Alright,
let's set the autopilot, and no, it's not going to hold, is it?
Alright, I've done it pretty. I'm almost done with the.
So I am at 490 knots, I think, on map 1852.
I'm doing 459 true airspeed.
So I'm faster than yesterday
I was flying my 737, and for some reason it was pretty slow. I'm going to have to try to fix that. But it was going at 30,000 feet true airspeed. It was probably 350. No, less than 350 knots. Probably has to be fixed.
I cruise with my Captain Sim 777 at 219 knots, not true airspeed, and it goes fine.
I go up to 35,000 feet. In my Captain Sim
777. I usually sit around 35,000, usually, no matter what aircraft I'm using, unless I'm using an IL 86. I can't usually go above 30,000 in the IL 86. It doesn't like it.
Yeah, but in my Captain Sim 777, I usually go 35,000 at 305 knots, not true airspeed. That gives me a little bit more true airspeed, 500 knots. That fits me exactly.
I should just fill the
flight man, just a question.
Oh man.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Better out than in.
Do you get the 777-300?
Yeah, I bought the 777-300.
Okay, good. I did
like
too.
I actually bought it. I never fired it, but
Can you guys check my stream and tell me how the audio is there? Do I need to... Alright. So, the music's alright, and the, my voice is too?
Everything's fine.
Alright, thank you.
I think how I look sexy. Just kidding.
Now, why are you off the flight path again? Come on, get on it. The autopilot was never too good in this plane. Alright, I reckon this will be about a 2 hour long flight. 2 to 3 hours. Actually, oh no, we already went over Lilyhammer.
Lilyhammer?
Yeah.
Lilyhammer.
Never heard of Lilyhammer.
It's a small town. Yeah, I don't think you would know of it. I've only heard of it because it was a...
Little Hammer.
I only heard of it because there was a Netflix show on the town. It's the only way I heard of it. And I did a flight from there last night. I did a flight to Lilyhammer about 2 weeks back.
Cool.
Why did you choose Lilyhammer specifically?
So in the show Lilyhammer, it's about a mob boss who goes into witness protection and he relocates from New York City to Lilyhammer in Norway. And he found out about Lilyhammer because he watched the 94 Olympics there. But anyways, I decided to sort of reenact that flight, so I flew from New York to Lilyhammer.
Ah, Lilyhammer.
It's spelled differently in the show, but it's spelled differently in real life than it is in the show.
Yeah. Yeah, Lilyhammer. Lilyhammer.
That's how they say it in Norwegian.
Lilyhammer. Like that? Yeah, I think like that.
Probably.
I'm probably right. I'm always right. Just kidding.
Alright, this is a good song. Let's get this up. I'm actually gonna get switched to my Russian hat. Yeah, this looks nice. Yeah. Oh, that's loud. Alright, this should be better. It's gotten quiet in Discord. Oh, okay, you guys are still here.
Just working on getting a flight. I got a coffee.
I'm back. So
when I do a flight, I'll have the extra stuff.
I gotta go clean my pet fish.
Alright, see ya, Rav.
Enjoy your $20.
Yeah, I don't know what I'll spend on. I'll be back in about 10 minutes. See ya.
See ya.
Alright, I'm gonna film. Yeah, 737 is my favorite aircraft. My favorite Boeing aircraft. I'll just be getting the PMP one. I won't be getting the PMDD one because it'll probably be very expensive. And like I said, I'm broke.
Yeah.
So, to be honest, the PMP one will probably be good enough for me. And probably you.
Also, the 2154 that I have, actually, you don't need to convert it. If I have the Google Drive to it, you just download it and swap it into your community folder.
Really?
Yeah, you don't need to convert it.
If you send it to me?
Yeah, let me find that.
because it would be a little bit helpful. No, actually, no, you don't have to.
Alright.
Fine, I'll convert myself to be a little bit better.
Alright. Let's get a different yeah, this one looks pretty cool. I'm gonna keep this one for a while. I like the bike helmet, looks pretty nice. I'm tired. Meantime, let's actually set up a showcase camera here. Yeah, cruising in style, just like they did in the USSR. Zoom out a bit. Yeah, that looks nice. That looks nice. Previewers, welcome, previewers. Thank you for tuning in tonight. Alright, let's put on some new music.
15 minutes,
nope, I don't want the ad to go away.
My first idea was, in 1/4 of an hour, your savings will tower. But that's not catchy. So I thought, 15 minutes, 15% serendipity.
Geico.
You know that your thumbnail is like a stream starting soon screen. Oh wait, it's
yeah.
Back to
yeah. I've been having some problems with my thumbnail on this stream. I'm gonna check it.
Yeah, make sure it's the thumbnail that it's supposed to be.
Right now, it's the custom one that I set. Oslo to Small Barn and 2154 Norway fly out. The Norwegian flag and then number 166 in the corner. It's the one I set it for.
Yeah. You have 2.76k subscribers. May I ask, are you even making any money from your channel or not?
Nope, not even monetized.
Really?
Yeah, I don't have enough hours.
Really?
Yeah.
What if I just... What a shame.
Yeah. I mean, if I was monetized, I'd make about maybe a couple $100 a month. So not like that much.
Yeah, but at least that would be good enough for you to put money back into your videos. Like buying add-ons to review and stuff.
Yeah.
Shame. I really hope your channel grows. So you can, you know, get that monetization. Really.
Yeah, I'm actually going to check my hours right now. Brett's actually got some... Brett actually, I think, makes some money off of YouTube.
He does. Yes, he has said. He has stated that he does.
I don't know, like, how much he makes, but...
Yeah, but if, you know, if you're able to make a few hundred bucks a month, even, like, 100 bucks a month, that would be good enough to buy some add-ons for, you know, or buy other games to review and all that.
Yeah.
So you can, you know... And, you know, get some quality content out, you know? You're already making quality content, like, but, like, at least you'd be able to review more things, you know?
Yeah.
If you got that, but, you know, you're doing this mostly for fun anyways.
Yeah.
And, you know, to entertain people and all that. So that's good. You're doing good on that, but... you got a nice website.
Oh, yeah, I haven't updated that in a while.
You might want to, because it said I've made numerous Grand Theft Auto 5 productions since 2016, but I'm planning to start making Roblox music videos and other gameplays.
I haven't updated that in a while.
And then change the I want to hit 5,000 subscribers by December 31st, 2020. Maybe change that to another time.
Yeah.
But right. Other than that, it does look good. Just some things that have to be updated, you know.
Yeah, they just need to be updated.
I made a website for my channel. I'm not going to tell you what it was, but it was a .com. It was like a real website, you know. I took it down, but, you know, it wasn't .webly like yours was. I actually put some money into making the website, so that was nice. But it ended up not being worth it because I didn't get any traffic at all, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know. And I wouldn't recommend you pay any money for a website because, you know, might not be worth it for how much traffic you're getting. But otherwise, your website does look good. Does look very professional for sure. So... And most YouTubers don't even make a website. Like, some of the biggest YouTubers don't even bother. But, you know, you did. So, kudos to you for that one. But other than that, I really have to go.
Alright, see ya.
See ya.
I do need to update my website. William Franklin, I Finn Flund it. Very laggy. Yep, sorry, William. Yeah, sorry if it is laggy. I apologize if it's lagging. I have a bad GPU, but it appears to have stabilized. Sorry it took me a while to get to your comment. Sorry I didn't see your comment. Alright. It is quite hot where I am. What's the climate looking like where all you guys are from? We recently got a heat wave. I'm actually going to check the weather on my phone. 79 degrees. No, 82 degrees right now where I am. It's going to be 88 later today. Tomorrow it's going to be 90 and rain and a thunderstorm at the end. It's going to be hot all next week. Alright, let's get some... Why isn't it not playing now?
You have no idea what your teams can accomplish until you've tried Monday.com.
Yeah. So what's the weather looking like where you guys are from?
I lied, I'll be here for a few more minutes, lol.
Alright.
One thing I definitely want, definitely am showing interest in, is the CRJ. I've considered starting to save up money for that, but I'm not going to. It's just not worth it for me.
There's a cracked one. It's free.
No, like I said, I don't pirate anything, you know.
Yeah, I wouldn't have flown it in a while. I mean, I paid for it, and I probably shouldn't have bought it. I flew it only a few times. The autopilot doesn't even work.
Yeah, like I said, if I'm gonna get any add-on, I would buy it. Any payware, at least. I would buy it. Like, that's the way I look at it. You have to support the developers. You have to get it in the way that you're supposed to get it, in my opinion. So, in the case that it's payware, and it's just too much, I'm not going to get it. But, yeah, it's definitely very beautiful aircraft. I wish I had the money. I don't, so I'm just, you know, going on with the Freeware FSX converted CRJ. That's fine for me because I don't do study level flying. So the, you know.
Oh, this one looks cool. This is
Freeware
a cool filter.
FSX, one that I've made, converted from FSX and stuff. They haven't released it though, but have converted it for FSX. The Freeware. The one that came with it. The Freeware. Made the Freeware one, but I haven't distributed it. It's okay though. But, anyways. My Freeware one's good enough for me.
Let's see whatever filters there are here. That's it. Okay, that one just looks weird. You got some rock playing? No, let's see what else we got. 3D horror. Okay, that just looks weird. Some of these just look wicked weird, some of these filters.
How far until you get up there, Ray?
Okay, there's a shark one, but that one doesn't look too good. Well, I still got quite a long way to go across Norway. Oh, good, maybe 2 hours.
2 hours till you get to your destination?
Yeah, it's a long flight.
It's gonna be a long stream.
Yeah, this is gonna be a long one. It might be even four. So maybe like total, so like 3 to 4 hour stream. Okay, that's for a mobile phone. That one doesn't work.
Wow, 3 to 4 hour stream. I usually like to do short flights, you know.
Yeah.
Like I did a stream once. It was literally from one place in Washington to another. 5 minute flight just to show off my Freeware 737.
Yeah, for my showcases, I do short flights, but for, we got a ton of cool filters here, but for streams, the ideal length, I think, is about maybe hour to, like, an hour and a half is the ideal length.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, because then you could get all kinds of people in there. I just didn't have the time really to stream for an hour.
Yeah, and if it gets long, if it's like 2 hours or if it's longer than 2 hours, it gets kind of boring. But I've done, you know, yeah. I've done three hour streams before.
Yeah. Wasn't fun, I'm guessing.
Yeah, it got pretty boring. Except the Russia one. Oh, it's an anime filter. Alright, I'm gonna turn all filters off for now. The Russia one, the Russia flyouts that I did with Red, those are both around the 3 hour mark. But they were quite fun though, so.
Yeah.
So they were worth it.
To be honest, I have to. Maybe I'll do like a flight in the Concorde or something. You know. Maybe somewhere in the US to another. Because, for example, I can get from New York to Los Angeles in less than an hour and a half. So maybe I can do that kind of flight, you know?
Yeah.
Or an hour flight in my 737, you know?
Yeah.
You know, maybe New York to Chicago kind of situation, you know?
New York to Chicago is about 2 hours.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I did it with Brett. I did a flight with Brett, JFK to Chicago. I did that in the 717, and he used the 727.
Mm-hmm.
And it was about 2 hours also.
Climb? 2 hours? Wow, okay. Maybe New York to Boston, then. That would probably be like a half hour.
Yeah, I've done that one, too. That was actually the first on-screen flight that I did.
How long was that, New York to Boston?
I think it was like an hour in real life, but I sped it up. Yeah, okay, JFK to Chicago, I used the 717, and then Brett used his own, Brett did a stream. So it was about like hour 50, so yeah, almost 2 hours.
Really?
Yeah, JFK
That's
to Chicago.
Crazy, because...
JFK to Baltimore is pretty short. I did it
I'm talking JFK to Boston.
JFK to Boston is probably about an hour. I did JFK to Baltimore with Brett. That one took about 47 minutes. That was actually
47?
Yeah, that was actually the...
Maybe I'll do a JFK to Baltimore stream then.
Yeah, that was the... That was actually the first stream I did with Brett. The first flight we did together. Yeah. I think Washington, D.C. to Miami might be pretty cool.
Oh, yeah, that would be pretty cool. I did a flight from Miami up to JFK in the Captain Sim 777, JFK's 777. It's actually a real route. They do, indeed do, flights from Miami to JFK in the 777-300. Because
I guess it's
just a jumper flight.
I think the plane must be just so packed. It's such a popular flight, so that they have to use bigger aircraft, and I guess.
Yeah, or maybe it's a jumper flight. So maybe, like, it did a long haul to Miami, and then they have to get it to JFK to do a long haul, and then, you know.
So, yeah, maybe it like so, that. Yeah.
And then they're just going to let passengers on, because why waste the fuel and stuff? I don't know.
So, yeah, it could have been a jumper flight.
It's what they're doing on, like, all over the summer. So, I don't know.
Honestly, though, I can't understand why people would want to go to Miami in the summer from New York. In New York, it's already hot. Why would you want to go to Miami where it's only hotter and more humid?
Because it's nice down there.
But it's just so hot. See, it's so hot and so humid. Like, it would make sense to go to Miami in the winter. When it's cold here, you want to get away. So, I shouldn't have done that. It would make sense, but...
I'm going to be honest. I live in the New York area, too, okay? And...
Are you in the city or are you, like, upstate?
In New York area.
Oh, so you're down south. I'm upstate.
Well, I live in, like, right outside the city, okay?
I know what that is. I know what you mean.
probably a little bit down south. But anyway, I like, you know, I like going to Florida in the summer. It's definitely something I've done before. Just to go to Disney World and stuff. But,
I've never actually been to Disney World.
Well, to be honest, it was when I was 6. I barely remember it anymore.
Oh.
Probably not gonna go again, because, you know, starting, you know, Disney's mostly for little kids, you know.
Yeah. Rev's not back.
So it's definitely something that,
welcome.
Is something that I do sometimes. It's just, you know, people like to go down to Florida in the summer because it's Florida.
Yeah.
Like, it's just that it makes sense to people. Because everyone's at school in the summer. Because, like, imagine calling your kid out 5 times. We're out of school during the summer, and so are we really going to call out of school 5 times in a week to go to Florida? So we go during the summer. We would probably, you know,
yeah,
go during the summer just to make sure that, just because that's the best time to go overall, so you don't have to call out to school, you know, 5 times.
Alright, Heisen 1646 is down below me. I don't think he's flying with me. I think he's just doing his own thing. I'm a bit off my flight path. 5 viewers, welcome 5 viewers. Alright, now let's actually see what our current airspeed is. 536 knots to miles per hour. 660 miles per hour, so we're actually doing not bad.
Why, I mean, obviously, West Washington still fans or anything, but I don't know why he gets more views. This is only because subscribers, like, I don't really understand that.
Well, Brett's been doing more streaming than I have.
So you think before looking to see when he's streaming more than you because you don't stream as often?
I'm not sure actually how I get. I'm doing pretty much everything Brett is doing. But yeah, I'm not getting as many views. Brett's in bed right now, or no, he's watching Formula One, I think. Either that or he's in bed right now, but I don't know actually why he gets. I guess he's just lucky. He was getting better views than I was when we first started doing stuff together. He had like 300 subscribers, and he was getting more views than I was.
Yeah.
And now he's at like, what, 1,500 now? And he's still getting more.
You see, really, I'm not trying to. I'm not really in the YouTube department. I'm not that. I just have a YouTube channel. I just had a YouTube channel to show off my plane. And that video ended up being very successful. It got over 2,000 views. But I still only have 4 subscribers. And to be honest, I'm okay with that. Because I have a Discord server with over 600 members.
Why do you have such a big Discord?
Basically, when I made mine and when I posted my things on Twitch.to, what I did is I slapped a little link to my server. Okay?
I think
what ended up happening, hundreds of people joined.
I think actually that's how I think that's actually how Brett has such a big how he gets such good views is he has a very big Discord. He has like 400 members, so I have like 30 people in my Discord.
So basically, like, if you think about it, between those thousands of downloads, my Discord server before I posted the planes had 100 members. Then it doubled to 200. Then it doubled to 400. Then it went to 500. And then it's almost
600. Yeah.
So I think it's the possibility. If I announce when streaming on my Discord server, I might get 4 viewers, you know?
Yeah, that's what I do. I usually announce it when I'm streaming. I haven't done it for this stream yet, but I will in a bit.
You know, like, how many people are online right now? I got 75 people online on my server. Okay, plus my two moderators. One of them's Red.
I got 10 online right now.
My owner. So that's 75, 76, 77. I got 78 online right now. Imagine announcing the 78 people that I am streaming. I might bet 10 people that decide to join. You know what I'm saying? So maybe that's something. Maybe that's a tactic I should try.
Maybe. I mean, I just pinged everyone on my server, and,
Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, you know.
I only got 10 online, and I got 34 that are offline.
24. Yeah. Yeah. I'm thinking of maybe just trying that tactic. If I try that tactic, definitely is a possibility that it would work. Because, people, here's the thing, right thing, people often go to, people often make a notification for this thing, and so when they, when I ping someone, or when I ping all my members, well, comes up. Oh, look, like me, he's streaming. And you click on it. He gets streaming. How many people out of 75 people are gonna do that? Maybe 10 people? That's 10 views on my stream. I think they'd be considering that.
Yeah, 10 viewers, that's pretty good.
You know, so maybe I should try that. I'm really thinking of maybe doing this there. Maybe in the captain's room, 777. Maybe a quick US flight. Maybe Miami to New York, you know?
Alright, I'm gonna go get a drink. I'll be back in about 30 seconds. let's set up some new filters, actually.
Dre, I forgot to tell you to recommend to do something. So, you're 4 people down, okay? You're 4 people down. So you're 3 people down. Maybe make a hole, an owner roll, and then make it display, separate from all online members. And then, so you'll have, the owner roll.
So, how do I set up my owner roll?
I mean, you can make a roll, make a new roll. I mean, if you want, I can do it.
Alright, yeah, I'll do that. Alright, we're a bit high up, so I'm gonna descend a little bit.
Oh yeah, you're at 37,000.
Rev's been gone quite a while. Alright, so we've had the rock playing, but in the meantime, let's actually get some new music. Okay. No, I don't want that. There's a potato. Oh, this is cool. If I move, I actually move. What if I stand up? Yo, I can go out of the ground. That is cool.
Right, do you have autopilot on?
Yes or no, it doesn't even work. Let me check.
Oh, you're out of the ground. There you go. Mr. Potato.
Oh my god, it looks so weird. Long nose. It looks so weird.
There you go, there's your... Just stay in the ground so you can keep going. Way you can,
Okay, this one just looks weird.
Oh, you look like Pinocchio. But instead your nose is floppy.
Alright. If I put my headphones down, I turn on the... bald one, it looks so cool.
Toilet plunger. What did William Franklin say? I firm fund it.
It looks so cool. The bald one.
Yeah.
But
I. What did William Franklin mean? I film bombed it.
Yeah, I don't know what he means by that.
We'll look up the definition of film fumming. Just to see what it is. That means I firm fun. It's just nonsense, honestly. Maybe. I might go for a while now, so I'm gonna go bye bye.
Alright, see ya. let's put this one. Set this one for now. This one looks pretty cool. Let's keep this one for now. I like it. I think it looks cool. Well, let's go with the Viking one. But if I put my hand up, it looks kind of weird. It doesn't look too good. Free viewers, welcome. Oh, yeah. Let's put some new music on. I turned the rock off, so I forgot to put the new stuff on. Let's turn up the desktop audio a bit. Let's find something here. Okay, two viewers, welcome. Alright, let's get back on the flight path. We're a bit off of it. Great plane. Wait, is that the Soviet flag or is that the Chinese flag? Oh, it's the Soviet flag, hammer and sickle. Thought it was the Chinese flag for a second. It's so hot where I am. Pretty playbacks, not bad. Alright, 5 likes, thank you everyone. In the meantime, let's actually descend a bit. Up 2154 service ceiling. Actually, a cool little thing I found on the 2154. I'll post it in the comments. It's a cool little story on it. The last one flew. I'm actually going to read this. So, workhorse Russian 2154 passenger chef flies into retirement. The last 254 passenger jet still in service in Russia has completed its final scheduled commercial flight. On October 28th, the Alrosa airline announced that the aircraft had flown from the Yakut region of city of Mirny to Siberia's Novosibirsk with 140 passengers. It was developed, the 2154 was developed by the Soviet Union Design Bureau and was the most widely used mid-range passenger aircraft in the Soviet Union. More than 1,000 of them saw service. The plane made its maiden flight on October 3rd, 1968 and was brought into regular commercial use in 1972. Production of the 2U-154 ended in 2013. The EU banned the 2154 in 2006 because of its high engine noise and fuel consumption. North Korea's Air Koryo still has two 154s in service. Although the 2154 has a satisfactory safety record considering its heavy use and demanding conditions, it has been involved in some predominant incidents. A Polish government 2154 with President Leech Kaczynski and other officials on board crashed in foggy weather near the Russian city of Smolensk in 2010, killing all 96 people on board. In December 2016, a military 2154 carrying 64 members of the Alexandronov Ensemble Military Corps crashed into the Black Sea while en route to Syria, killing all 92 people on board. Well, the 2154 is no longer flies in Russia, unfortunately. Free viewers, welcome free viewers. Oh no, okay, everyone left. Meantime, let's descend. Our altitude, we're a bit high. I've actually done some flights in the 2154 before, and I'm actually curious how long they were, so I'm going to look at those real quick. Alright, let's see. Alright, I did the Poliarny 2 alert flight, which was 3 hours and 53 minutes. Then London to, then Moscow to Heathrow. That one was 3.5 hours. So yeah, the... I'm actually curious what the longest stream...
I forgot to ask you something. One more thing about the...
Sure.
If you're rich, what plane would you get? Would you want to pilot it, so would you want to get your license to fly planes and then fly it yourself, or would you hire a private pilot?
I'd probably just go get my own license at that point.
Why?
Thank you.
You know, like, if you're gonna have a private jet.
I would probably get my own private pilot's license so I can fly, but I'd also probably hire a, so I can fly it if I want, but also he can fly it for me if I want him to.
Well, what I would probably do is I'd probably get my private pilot's license, then buy a 172, okay?
Yeah.
And then fly that myself, fly the 172 myself, and then when I want to use the private jet or the 757, I would get my private pilot. So my private pilot would fly the 757, and I would fly a 172. That would probably be my ideal situation.
Yeah, but I almost just spilled my water.
Yeah.
The thing I noticed is this cockpit is actually a little bit different than the one in my old 2154. I had one that said spare bulbs. There's a little door somewhere, but alright, I'm leaving someone's airspace. Oh man. Better out than in. Alright, I reckon we could probably pull up now. Oh man, we are doing 650 knots. ENLK. Where exactly is that? I know it's not our destination, is it? So it's only 10,000, it's about 1,000 miles, so theoretically it should be a 2-hour flight. If I'm doing 500, but I'm kind of doubtful of that. Uh-oh. We are doing freaking Mach 1 now. Something is going on. We are now doing Mach 1. I have no way to slow this thing down. Lay back off the accelerator. That only caused it to accelerate even more. Okay, we are now accelerating past Mach 1, ladies and gentlemen. Not good at all. We're now doing 2,000 knots. Let's put that into miles per hour. 2,000 knots to miles per hour. 2,300 miles per hour. That's about 2,300 to miles per hour to Mach. We're doing Mach 3 now, probably Mach 4. Oh boy, this thing is getting hard to control. Alright, 226.65 knots. So we've reached the top speed of 226.65. The plane will not accelerate past this amount. Alright, we're doing 3,066 miles per hour and put that into Mach. Miles per hour to Mach. That is, we're doing Mach 4 now. Mach 4, ladies and gentlemen. Well, we are being tossed around here. This is a lack of realism, but let's just hope the plane slows down eventually. Ow, damn it, I just hit my own eye. Meantime, let's lose the helmet. Alright, what if I take my gear out? Is that going to slow me down a lot? Nope, it has literally no effect. Taking the gear out does not slow me down at all. It slowed me down by one knot. If I take flaps full... Yeah, no, it doesn't do much. All it does is just gives me more lift. Yeah, it doesn't do much, unfortunately. Yep, nope. Retracting the flaps. Putting the flaps down and putting the gear down does not make much difference at all. I must admit, though, we've traveled quite a long way, so maybe... So yeah, maybe this will only be a 2-hour long stream, not a 3 to 4 hours I thought it would be. I'm going to do a 4th of July stream. I was thinking of doing a 4th of July BMG and a 4th of July flight sim. No, we're not losing much speed here. Have slowed down just a little bit, only by like 15 knots. We're now doing 2650 knots, so just below Mach 4. Alright, we're now at 2634 knots, so we've slowed down just a little bit. Alright, I like the Mr. Worm. It looks pretty cool. Mr. Worm. Oh lord, we are losing control now. I somehow managed to accelerate up to Mach 4 again while climbing at 89,000 feet per minute. Alright, we're gonna be at Svalbard in no time at this rate. Oh shoot, we are losing it. Poor passengers. Yeah, we're having some issues here. Whatever I just, okay, yep, all right, yep, great. All right, it appears we're slowing back down to our speed now. Only doing, yep, we are slowing back down, thank God. Keeping the gear and the wheels out for now. Ooh, you gonna eat that and left it for loose? We're still over Mach 1. Hey, Rev.
So, how long have I been gone for?
Maybe like an hour? My plane just sped up to like Mach 4 and I'm managed to slow it down, but I'm at about 1,000 knots now. So I'm sitting at 1,000 knots trying to slow down with my gear and flaps down. Alright, nope, I don't want that. Go away. Is pause break gonna do me any good? No, it doesn't.
Dad, it just had the most cursed ringtone.
Mm-hmm.
It literally sounds as like the end of the world.
Yeah.
Kept because it was like it sounded like scraping the board.
All right, I need to slow down somehow. This rate, we're gonna be a long year.
I've got to slow back.
No time.
It's been a long year, hasn't it?
The problem is, though, is the map does not work when you're this far north. For some reason, the VFR map don't work. Now, we are near some small...
You hit a speed bug.
Yeah. How do I get rid of that speed bug? I wish I would have had a speed bug.
Just smash into the ground and it should fix it. Make sure you keep your speed brake on.
Yeah, I don't know how to turn my speed brake on. I wish I could have somehow turned off the, I wish I could have had a speed bug on my way to, on my way to Rio in the last flight. Alright, we are currently over the Barents Sea, and we are near the island of Bjornøya. Oh, man. So this small little island right to my side... As a small
currently
little island of
Bjornøya.
I'm not over the DMZ.
True, sure are. Kidding.
Alright, Bjornøya Island in the balance. Alright, Bear Island is the southernmost island of this Norwegian Svalbard archipelago. The island is located in the western parts of the Barents Sea, approximately halfway between Spitsbergen and the North Cape. It was discovered by Dutch explorers in 1596. The area is 70 miles, and I don't believe anybody lives there. I'm going to look at it on Wikipedia.
Hey, so Dre, you have to Captain Sim 777-300, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good, then you should see me.
Alright, it has never been settled, and the remnants of a whaling station from the early 20th century can be seen there. There was a small coal mine there.
What's your nearest airport?
Probably Longyear. I don't think there's anything on Bear Island.
Well, I'm just gonna sit 20 minutes away. Bro, you're literally about to leave the atmosphere.
Oh, yep, and I've accelerated up to Mach 4 again.
This is the Tupolev 154 mission to space.
Yeah.
No, come on, you have to pass 60,000 feet, please.
Alright, well, might as well.
Just a disappointment to measurable with that.
Yeah, let's climb up to 50, and then let's... And I already see the island of Longyear.
I'm gonna serve to you real quick.
Alright, 60k. Now let's go back down and smack it to the ground.
I'll be
to fix this.
If you want it to 60, if you went to 69k.
Yeah, I'm not going there. Alright, so if I slam it to the ocean, that should slow me down.
Yeah, hopefully. That's what works for me.
Oh man, we are losing it here.
I can't salute you.
For more information on COVID-19
okay,
vaccine,
I see you moving, but you are absolutely gunning it.
To you by YouTube and the vaccine.
Oh no, I'm dying. Oh. It's weirded. The VFR map does not work, actually.
Yeah, it doesn't work at such Nordic altitudes. When you're so far north, it doesn't work.
Well, lucky for me, I have autopilot. And a nerve system built into my Captain Sims 7. I don't feel like taking the Captain Sims 7, so I'm gonna buy a plane.
I'm gonna try and slam it to the ocean. Oh well, I've actually fixed the speed bug.
I told you.
I didn't even slam into it, I just descended really hard.
Man knows best.
Alright, let's get back out of here then. Alright, so some history on Svalbard. It was originally discovered, the island, the bigger island, was originally discovered in, damn it, I can't find it. Alright, I'm just going to open up some Wikipedia here. Alright, Svalbard, previously known as Spitsbergen, is a Norwegian archipelago on the Arctic Ocean, north of mainland Europe. It is about midway from the northern coast of Norway and the North Pole. It's a group of islands. The largest is Spitsbergen, followed by Nordfjordeis and Norøya. The largest settlement is Longyearbyen. The islands were first used by whalers who sailed far north in the 17th and 18th centuries, after which they were abandoned. Coal mining started in the beginning of the... Coal mining started in the beginning of the 20th century. Several permanent cities were established. The Svalbard Treaty of 1920 recognizes Norwegian sovereignty, and the 1925 Svalbard Act made Svalbard a full part of the Kingdom of Norway. They also established Svalbard as a free economic zone and a demilitarized zone. The Norwegian Store Norsk and Russian Arctool remain the only mining companies in place. Research and tourism have become important supplementary industries. The University Center in Svalbard and the Svalbard Global Seed Vault playing critical roles in the economy. Apart from Longyearbyen, other settlements include the Russian mining community of Barentsburg, the research station of New Iceland, and the mining post of Svalbard. Other settlements are farther north, but populated only by rotating groups of researchers. No roads connect the settlements. Instead, snowmobiles, aircrafts, and boats are used for inter-settlement transport. Svalbard Airport Longyearbyen serves as the main gateway. Uh-oh, speed bump again. Speed bug.
Okay. Slam into the ocean once again.
All right. I want to finish reading this, though. So... approximately 60% of the archipelago is covered with glaciers, and the islands feature many mountains and fjords, so the cliffs. Archipelago is an Arctic climate with significantly higher temperatures than other areas at the same latitude. The flora is adapted to take advantage of long period of midnight sun to compensate for the polar light. Svalbard is a breeding ground for many seabirds and is home to polar bears, reindeer, and Arctic foxes, as well as certain marine mammals. 7 national parks and 23 nature reserves cover 2/3 of the archipelago, protecting the largely untouched yet fragile natural environment. While part of the Kingdom of Norway since 1925, Svalbard is not part of geographical Norway administered. The archipelago is not part of any Norwegian county, but forms an unincorporated area administered by a governor appointed by the Norwegian government. Special jurisdiction to the Svalbard Treaty is outside the Nordic Passport Union economic. Alright.
Type A. Might get that.
Yeah. So I'm just...
£15 in my bag. Don't know what to spend it on.
Alright, so it was originally discovered in 1596. Actually, no, 1604 it was discovered. There was some Russian activity there in the early 1800s, but it was deceased when they lost the war. Now, 20th century history. By the 1890s, Svalbard had become a destination for Arctic tourism. Coal deposits have been found in the islands are being used as a base for Arctic exploration. First mining company was Iceforge N by formed by the Norwegians in 1899. Oh, there it is. I gotta go back to it.
Ray, if I plugged in with the DC6, would your game probably crash?
Probably. Discussions to establish the archipelago commenced in the 1910s were interrupted by World War I. In 1920, the Svalbard Treaty was signed, granting full sovereignty to Norway. However, all signatory countries were granted non-discriminatory rights to fishing, hunting, and mineral resources. And then the first governor, Johannes Greckens Basso, took office. The archipelago has been traditionally known as Spitsbergen, and the main island is Westbergen. By the 1920s, it was renamed Svalbard. Russians have traditionally called the archipelago Gourmand. The Soviet Union retains the name Spitsbergen and support the undocumented claims that Russians were first to discover the land. In 1928, an Italian explorer, Umberto Noble, the crew of an airship Italia crashed in the ice pack off the coast of Huon Island. There were rescue attempts covered in the press, and a short-lived fame was received as a result. Second World War, Svalbard, known to the British and Germans as Spitsbergen, was little affected by German invasion of Norway in 1940. The settlements continued to operate, mining coal and monitoring the weather. And then, in July 1941, I've got to pause again to finish reading. Then, in 1941, Germans invaded the USSR. The Royal Navy reconnoitered the islands of Revue, using them as a base of operations. Sends supply to North Russia, but the idea was rejected as impractical. Alright, well, this isn't too much interesting. Post-war, it was, Norway reestablished operations. Yeah. Now, Norway reestablished operations at Longyearbyen and Nuashtal. Well, the Soviet Union established a mining community in Barentsburg, Pyramid, and Gourmand. And, there were a few accidents there. And, let's see.
Speaking of accidents, England has 46.
Yes. Petroleum was there drilled from 1963 until 84. From 1960, regular charter flights were made from the mainland to a field at Hotelenst. In 1975, Svalbard Airport Longyear opened fully, allowing year-round services. During the Cold War, the Soviet Union compromised about two-thirds of the population on the islands. Norwegians were about one-third. Population of the archipelago was slightly under 4,000. Russian activity has diminished since then, falling from 2,500 to 450 people from 1990 to 2010. Grumont was closed after it was depleted in 62. Pyramid and closed in 1998. Coal exports from Barentsburg ceased in 2006 because of a fire, but resumed in 2010. The Russians experienced two air accidents. Nukova Airlines 2801, which killed 141 people, and the Hero Rod and helicopter accident, which killed 3 people. Longyearbyen remained purely a company town until 1989, when cultures separated into Svalbard. In 1993, it was sold to the national government, and the university was established. tourism increased in the 90s, and that's pretty much it. Nothing really happened after that. Alright, anyways, I'm gonna try and fix my speed bug now. Uh-oh, what did I just do?
I think I need to restart my game.
Yeah, I just closed my YouTube stream by accident. I need to reopen that.
I know, even if you close it, it still works.
I know that, I just need to reopen it.
So I can finally load into Charles de Gaulle.
Alright, in the meantime, let's keep fixing this.
So, Dre, I'm probably gonna change my main airport to Heathrow.
Alright. Alright, now I'm just parked on the water.
The water cold?
Probably. I mean, I managed to fix the speed bug.
God, there's actually so many options, I don't know what to get. Off the demo, we're 15.
Now I'm having engine troubles. Alright, now I just need to find the airport. Now, my VFR won't work. My heading is 1 degree. Heading is 1. There's a taunt on 99 here. Don't think he's with us.
Pick 4 random letters. I want to see if that'll be an airport code.
K-A-L-B.
Albany, alright then. Scenery for that, I have to get it, you know.
Alright, there it is, everybody. Svalbard.
How do you get your, like, gauges to be clean? Because mine's got yellow stuff all around them. It looks like piss.
Where did you get your 2154?
Okay.
Alright.
Same one as you.
Well, this one was... I cleaned the gauges out. There's a file that cleans them out. I'll send you my 2154.
Okay, thanks.
Right, my VFR does not work here. Alright, if I hold heading 1, it should take me right to Longyear.
What makes you think of that limp? It's been quite a long year so far, you know?
Yeah, this wouldn't be as long as the streams I thought it would be, actually. Thought it was gonna be like a 3 to 4 hour, but it's gonna be right around the 2 hour mark.
Tried to make a pun with a long year, but it didn't work. Nobody laughed.
Hasn't been that long a year for me.
Yeah, I should save up for the T-45. My Wi-Fi disconnect. Is it good?
Alright, my heading will not hold.
Moment of truth, is there scenery for Albany? There is not.
Alright, Rev, where are you at?
To restart my game.
Oh. There's a Taunt on 99. Don't think he's with us, but hello, Taunt on 99. I don't know what the hell he's doing out here.
You get the A4 Skyhawk. That seems cool.
I have no idea what he's doing out here because.
Probably trying to get your attention.
And now he just disappeared, so I guess he just left too.
Oh my god, this is literally so hard to decide what to get.
Yeah, alright, coming in for some clouds here. We are in a little bay.
I think I'll get this little airport called EGTR from Orbex. Because Orbex make the best airports.
Alright, I'm gonna speed up. There's no reason to be crawling through here. Reckon we still got some time before we get to Longyear.
Yeah. Still got a long year ahead of us. There's a lake next to it. Maybe I'll use that as my main airport, actually. GTR. Should probably be my main airport now.
Nice one. Oh, I've hit a speed bug again. Alright.
I was gonna go real. I said car instead of plane. Those things because I flew
it. Alright, let's slam into the mountains. Hopefully that'll fix the speed bug.
Stored like 97 watts for the BMNG. So I got a 458. A Viper.
Yep, nope, slamming us in the mountain didn't work, but if I just slew onto the ground. Now if I slew out. Yep, that seems to work.
Alright, where's this airport I paid for? Yes, believe it or not, paid.
Alright, let's actually contact Longyear. I reckon we ought to be near the airport. Airport's closer to you.
The closest airport to me?
Yeah, to me, but it's not even showing up.
Come on.
It won't even show
up.
I
didn't even consider getting Manchester. How stupid am I? T-154 is a really nice plane, not gonna lie.
Yeah, it is. It was built for like 45 years, too. It was in production for quite a while.
Didn't steal Manchester, I forgot. I guess I'm stupid then. Oh, so Manchester has two runways. Oh. I'm very stupid. I won my aren't I?
Thank you. let's get some music in here.
So Dre.
Yeah.
Has this ever happened to you when like you try to remember something but you can't remember it, but then you absolutely remember it the next day?
Yep, all the time.
Because I just was like, oh, I thought that everything had autopilot, but I don't know which one it was, and then I realized it was the Embraer 141 Spandamari or whatever. I'm gonna come over to you. Wait, why is Das Auto over here? What are you doing over here?
Das Auto's here?
Yeah, he's at Heathrow, I think.
Oh. Are you at Longyear right now, Rev?
Yeah, I am.
Alright. It'd be easier if you stay there, because I don't have a VFR, so it's easier to find the airport if you're right there.
Yeah, I'm trying to just dip some thing around it, but too big to eat better. That's what she said.
Another speed thing. Another speed bug.
Just leave it. If you want to get that quicker, then might as well just hit the speed bug and you can get stupid tip left 144. Why does Russian planes really annoy me?
Tons of times. Alright, Google Map, Longyear. I want to find where it is on Google Maps.
Dre, watch out. About to come and literally destroy your plane.
What are you in? Alright, never speed, bro.
And like I said, just leave it.
No, it's gonna be hard slowing down once I get there, that's the thing. But I haven't noticed this slewing into the ground works, but smashing in doesn't.
Me smashing does. The small bump. Or I think you should say the line.
Alright, I reckon I'm coming up on Longyear.
What do you think of this one? It doesn't feel good wasted if it feels good tasted.
Never speed bug.
I'm gonna make 21, so I might escort you.
Alright.
Coming over to you, I'm about to escort you.
Damn it. Whenever I slew, it just tries to put me down. I see you zooming.
And now I'm dead. Well, I'm still alive, but kind of half dead. So just over these mountains, long years there. So I recommend where you are taking the right and you're getting right up.
Alright, we are coming in on Longyear.
Take a right and where you are, and then you'll see the right.
I see it.
So get lined up, and then do what I'm doing, because I just hit speed.
Take some gear. Those flaps gave me some lift. Alright, cut the music for
mine
now.
Mine too. These flaps aren't really doing anything for me, to be honest. They're just making everything 10 times freaking worse.
You're giving me too much lift. I'm a bit high.
And me too, in both ways.
Alright, if I put them away, that might help. Looks to be an actually like a big settlement. I see some big, you know, office buildings. But
I also see some big ships, like an oil tanker and a bulk, maybe.
Don't think there's many of those up here.
Oh shit, this is gonna be a terrible landing. Oh shit. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Longyear. It appears that we have died, but thank you for flying with us either way. You're gonna have to pay for your tickets.
Alright, flaps full now. Let's try and get a butter.
Inside the terminal. I'm gonna watch this landing, Gray.
Yep, and no, I just crashed into this building.
I saw that.
Alright, let's try that again. I haven't had much luck on my landings lately.
Yeah. Try and get the approach right, and then what you wanna do is you wanna get the back set of gear down like really smoothly, like do every like the first set of wheels, then the second set, and the third set, one wheel 1 second apart, and then that will be a butter. Make sure to come in at least 160 knots.
Yeah, that was probably why I was doing like 140.
So just try and come in a bit fast and then go as smooth as you can. I should definitely install this cache thing for Longyear or something.
Alright, let's sit at about 180. Better burp it up, taste it, and fart it, and waste it.
You challenged me, didn't you? Oh. It's always absolutely beautiful.
Alright, can you get your drone on me?
I got it on you.
Alright, thanks.
Should I record then? Should I record it?
Yeah, record it.
Give it to you? I'll record it with OBS, just give me a minute.
Alright, you got it running?
Got it running, don't worry.
Alright, you got it recording, alright.
Can I upload it to my channel too?
Yeah, sure.
I don't know how to convert it, to be honest, like convert the right resolution, because I'm dumb at editing. I'm gonna get a good view of you, and I'm gonna watch this. Rotation speed.
I shall have to speed up.
Cool. When I get to the runway, see this beautiful landing. Expect it to be good.
Alright, nose is a bit. My nose is down too much.
Probably gonna be a bit too long, so I'm gonna stop playing and start recording again.
Alright.
That was absolutely beautiful, Dre. Absolutely.
That was
beautiful.
A bounce.
The first touchdown was amazing, and the second one was absolutely amazing.
Alright, those reversers are working. Yeah, that was a bad landing. That was a bounce.
From my view, it was amazing. I'll send you the clip. How should I send it to you?
Through Discord.
But I don't have Nitro.
Then a Google Drive. Alright, I'm gonna turn around at the end of the runway and then come to the terminal.
I'm dumb because I don't know how to upload to do Google Drive. Oh, wait, never mind. I managed to get it to you. Yep.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Longyear.
It's been quite a long year of a flight, but, you know, our services are terrible and you get what you get. Say that.
Alright, now I should turn, now I need to turn around here at the end of the runway. What are you in?
May 21.
Okay.
This thing hauls ass. This scenery reminds me of Zurich, and Zurich is absolutely beautiful. This looks like the real thing. Why do I hear a plane veering to my house faster and faster every second? Not good.
All right, turn around.
And I'm gonna actually slam this onto the ground, so you might want to record this and put this into a shot.
I'm still, well, I'll download the stream after, get some good shorts out of this.
Right. Can you maybe teach me how to convert the shorts into like, the video into like shorts for us?
Yeah.
Got a voice crack, I think.
I didn't notice one. Alright, in the meantime, let's put the flaps up.
I need to get this May 21 down or else I want to, or else, well, this won't go out.
It is wicked hot where I am.
It's humid where I am. At this point, I wouldn't even mind to just bathe in literal ice. Make 21 loop, let's see this. That's gonna be some good shorts content. You can watch my landing.
Alright, yeah, sure. Alright, let's see Rev's landing. How far are you out from the airport?
About two.
Like, when do you think you're gonna land?
You good? You got this spot on. Which is not that good, but who gives a shite? Okay, here goes nothing. Land slowly.
I don't see this landing.
I'm not gonna make onto the runway.
You're not, you didn't even land on the runway.
Yeah.
You landed on the grass and flipped.
Yeah. Yeah, this will make good shorts content.
Three
shorts off this. Epic. Just another day on Microsoft Flight Simulator multiplayer.
Alright, let's park right here.
Get a photo of us real quick.
Alright, powering down the engines.
Can you just get a photo? Mind.
Alright, well, this has been a great flight. Thank you for everybody who joined the stream, and thank you for everyone who joined the flight. Alright.
I got a screenshot. Good.
Alright, well, anyways, I'm gonna wrap this one up. Well, anyways, I guess that wraps up for the stream. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. Please subscribe if you want more streams like these, and have a good day.